press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello children, how are you? I hope that all are doing good. Is it? So today I am going to deal with the lesson. The name of the lesson is The Comet Second. So in Comet First, we come to know about how Dattada has discovered a new comet. Is it? So later, astronomers, the scientists and astronomers, they have come to the conclusion that if this new comet, which was discovered by Dattada, so it was it is going to collide to Earth, is it? So like that, it is so dangerous to the Earth if it collide. So the whole life on Earth, it is going to spoil, destroyed. So that's why here in the next part, means in the first part, like the comet first, in the second half of the story, we come to know about how James, Dr. Forsyth, okay? Dr. James Forsyth and also John MacPherson, they both were have a conversation and they were having a private meeting. Okay, it's called a secret meeting, that they were discussed about the papers which was written by. Okay, the papers means it's about the calculations which was did by the Dr. Forsyth. He was a scientist. So John MacPherson, he come to know about, so something, if the calculations are right, then this comet is going to collide to the Earth, okay? So later they were having a discussion and they were come to the conclusion that they are having a international conference. They can call the experts from the all over the world to discuss about the serious issue, okay? If they could do it, means if they can avoid this problem, means they avoid this this collision, so they can, but they have to take some actions, no? So before they are going to sit and they are silent, they have to watch the destruction of the world. So they are thinking worriedly about how they have to stop this disasters, okay? So this is about the comet first. So let's see about the comet second in today's class. So what happened in the upcoming story, okay? Is it this comet is going to collide to Earth, or these people like scientists, astronomer, even the Dattada and other people, okay, they are the international experts. So they were trying to avoid this collision, or the comet has diverted its way, okay? So it has changed its way or not. Let's see in this today's lesson, is it? So here, Dattada is invited to the secret conference. How to change the course of comet Dattada is the scientist's hidden agenda, okay? So now Dattada, he is invited for a secret conference. I know, we already know in the comet first. So how, that is Dr. James Forsyth and also John MacPherson, they were having in conversation and they come to the conclusion, they call a international conference, is it? And not only those people are gathering there, even Dattada is also gathering to that conference. That's called a secret conference. How to change the course of comet Dattada is a scientist hidden agenda, okay? So this Dattada, because who has find out this comet? That is Dattada. So now all of the scientists, so it was a secret for the other people, for the world, that Dattada is, he only invented, but so for the scientists it will be the secret for it, okay? Then the Dattada and the defense advisor come close friends and share a secret. So who are the defense advisor? That is John MacPherson and Dattada. They both were come closer and they were become a friends. And they are sharing their secrets each other, okay? When they were having a conversation on telephone or they were meet. So they were having a secret conversation, okay? So you know that John MacPherson, he is in that department, okay? So he's working for the government. And he wanted to know all the information which was collected by the Dattada, okay? So this is the thing. Let's see about in today's class. By the time they finished their deliberations and the Sir John dropped him at his hotel off Regent Street, it was 1 a.m. So both are, so who is that? That is Dr. James Forsyth and also John MacPherson, they both were in a deliberations. They were in a secret meeting, okay? So now, Sir John, that is John MacPherson, he has dropped him in the car. He has dropped him. So where Dr. James Forsyth was living, okay? So it was a hotel. So he was in hotel, and it was a wretched street. It was a 1 a.m. So almost it's about a 1 o'clock at night. So he has dropped him. So where he was staying, that is in hotel, okay? There was hardly any crowd on the street, but when James looked up from his window, a star-studded night sky greeted him, okay? So the street where this hotel it is, and where John McPherson, he has dropped to, he has given a drop to James, Dr. James. So the street, it was totally empty. There are no single people are walking there, okay? So there is no crowd at all. So when he was went into the hotel, and when he was went to the room, so suddenly he just looked into the window and he could see the stars in the sky, okay? So what it is, how he felt? Stars stood at night, sky greeted him, okay? Stood it means winter tires. It was a the night which is very cold, okay? So where the sky is greeted him, the sky is giving a happily it is welcoming to James, okay? Then somewhere amongst these stars was Comet Datta, hiding for a collision with the earth. So while he was looking into the sky and he was watching stars, so there he just thought of it, that somewhere behind the stars, so the comet it is staying, okay? The comet is staying. It was a Datta comet, so which is staying behind the stars, and so it is planning for collision the earth, okay? So this is the thought when he was looking at the sky. It was hard to believe the calamity of the future on such a peaceful night. So later he just thought of the future, okay? Who? James Forsyth, Dr. James Forsyth. He could thought of the future then. So how it will be the future, okay? So when this earth is going to be destroyed. So now it is a peaceful night. So when he was looking at the sky, it seems like it is a peaceful night. But when this comet is going to collide to the earth, so it will be the disaster. So he is just thinking about that disaster, that calamity, okay? Then for a moment, James wondered if he had done his sums right. So then again he was thought of it, his calculations. So whatever the calculation is done, it is the right one, then the collision is the, it is going to be happen, okay? The destruction, it is going to be happen. If it is wrong, if his calculations are wrong, so if this collisions are not happen, okay? So there is no destruction on the earth. But if it is a right, that calculation, whatever he has done, so if it right, so then the disaster is happen. It is, no one is changed that fate. So this is, whatever doubt James may have had about Sir John's efficiency were quickly dispelled when he reported for the conference and found that all the experts listed by him were there, okay? So later he just thought of the John McPherson, who, so when he was thought of comet, then the stars, then the night and the future, then suddenly he just thought of thinking about John McPherson, okay? So he just thinking about John McPherson, he little bit earlier he just have little bit doubt on him, okay? When he rejected his papers and his calculation, he seems like he just doubting on that work of the John McPherson. Whatever he just assuming it, it was not true. He was doubted. Who? Dr. James Forsyth. But about Sir John's efficiency, but with his great efficiency, he had explain all those things to Dr. James James Forsyth, okay, were quickly dispelled when he reported for the conference. So when he called a sudden conference, okay, so whatever the calculation about, whatever the things he said about James McPherson's discovery, that is the calculation, so suddenly at the end he just come to the conclusion, that is he called a conference, okay, and found that all experts listed by him were there. So how many people, they are the experts, they are belongs to this field, so they can solve this problem, okay? So he just listed the names, and suddenly he just arranged all of the meeting and conference and the people who are going to be gathered in that conference, okay? So whatever the doubts he had, who Dr. James Forsyth, it was cleared now about John McPherson, okay? Then astronomers, computer scientists, nuclear physicists, space technologists, biologists, all were there. Okay, so in that particular conference, which is kept a secret and confidential, that meeting, so who are the people they are gathered? The people, they were in a different fields, okay? So they are the astronomers, the people they were belongs to, astronomy, then computer scientists, the people are the computer scientists, nuclear physicists, and also space technologists and biologists, all were gathered in that conference, international conference. Then, and as Sir John's special invitee was present, the man who had started it all, that is Manoj Datta, okay? So next, the last person who is in that list, that is the person who has discovered this comet, that is Manoj Datta, okay? So he has also one of the expert, and he was sent an invitation to Manoj Datta to come for this conference, okay? Who did the John McPherson, okay? Then, the conference lasted 1 week and went on under the total cover of secrecy. So that conference, it took for 1 week, okay? It takes a time of 1 week, and there it was under the total cover of secrecy. It is completely secret, okay? So there is no leakage of any news about this collision of the earth, okay? The comet is collided to the earth. So it is total, they kept under the secret. Then, first the experts checked and rechecked James Forsyth's calculation with the latest observation of the comet Datta, okay? So whatever the calculation has did by James Forsyth, so again, they were observing all the experts who are in that conference, they were gathered. So they were checking and rechecking it, okay? Again and again they are calculating and they are rechecking it. So they were just, and at last they were calculating the comet Datta also, okay? He was right. There was no escape from the direct hit predicted by him. Actually, whatever the calculation he has did, so actually it is a right. All the experts who were observing this calculation checking and rechecking it, and they were given that, they come to the conclusion. So whatever the calculation he has done, that is right one, okay? So that collision, the collision is going to be happen, okay? So the earth is going to be destroyed. So they have come to the conclusion. So next, what happened? There was a small chance that the comet may just graze the atmosphere of the earth and not collide. So along with this calculation, they have little bit of chance. So what is that chance? So that comet is going to be just graze means in a height scratch. They just scratch the earth, okay? So just when the comet is passed in nearby the earth, okay, when they are coming to hit on the earth, so they just a little bit of chance to just scratch the earth, okay? They can touch the earth's atmosphere. So it is a little chance of it, okay? But they are not sure. So they are not sure about the comet is going to be scratch the earth atmosphere, okay? So this is then not collide, and they are not sure about, they're just giving a small chance that it will be happen, okay? Then in that case, the loss of life and property would not be total if it will be happening. So what if that comet is going to be passed by the earth with the scratches, okay? If it scratch the earth atmosphere, so what will happen? So it will be the loss of the property and the lives, but it should be not calculated. So they can't calculate it how much the destruction will be happen on the earth, okay? But this slight respite was hardly reassuring enough for taking no action, okay? But this slight respite means relief. This relief was hardly reassuring, can restore. Okay, so whatever the destruction was caused when the comet is going to pass nearby the earth, so they can restore the property which they have lost it, okay? Enough for taking no action, but they can't take any actions. They have to restore it. Restore means they have to recover, means the relief actions, they can take it, okay? But having decided that some action was needed, what form should it take? Okay, so now the another question arises here. If it will be not happen, if the that action is not going to be happen, if that comet is not going to be passed by the Earth's atmosphere, so just they can hit to the Earth, they can collide to the Earth. So what will be? Then the experts dismissed defensive measures like living in a underground bunkers. It was a simply not a practical propositions, okay? So now they have another idea, okay? They have another solution. So they are having, means the experts, they call it as a bunkers. Bunkers means it's a hardened shelter under the ground. There are, you know, the military people, they are captured. The bunkers means it is using for the war battlefield. That is called weapons, okay? So it is under the ground, all the bunkers, it is there, okay? Then, so they have to take the advice from the defensive. Defensive means it's about a military, okay? Measures like living in a underground bunkers, it was simply not a practical propositions, okay? So it's not a simple one, but they have to be a practical. Practical about that, they have to utilize the explosives, okay? That is missiles and weapons, okay? Now this is. So the only course was to take offensive action. Comet Datta could be marginally deflected from its path by giving it a push. So now they come to the another solution, that this comet Datta, so just we need give a little bit push, okay? So they can change the way. So when that comet Datta, it is coming to collide to the Earth. So just they can give a little push. Push means just they can, they have to send any missile or explosion. Okay, when it is coming nearer to the Earth, so that it is, there is a slightly chances of it, they can change the way of the comet, okay? So then what, again they are giving a suggestion here. Then next is, the experts calculated that the bulk of destructive nuclear power available on the Earth would be needed to achieve this mammoth task. All the experts, means the experts from the defensive measures, means the defensive department, so they given an advice. So how much they need the power, means the nuclear power for explosion of that comet, they have, okay? They have conserved it, okay? And you know, all the things are available on the Earth, and they have to achieve this mammoth task. Mammoth means it's a very large task. You know, here, when the Earth, this is the Earth, when this comet is come and nearer to the Earth, okay? So when this comet is coming nearer to the Earth, so what they will do? So they just send a nuclear missile for an explosion. So when they just exploit this, when they explode it on the space, so what will happen? Either it will be destroyed, either it will be change its path. So this is the one solution, okay? So they should have to avoid this collision. So they can't come to reach to the Earth. So like that. And they want a lot of nuclear power here, okay? So they need the nuclear power. Nuclear explosion, you may call, okay? They want nuclear explosion. You know that how the nuclear missiles are very powerful. They can destroy a large part of the Earth, okay? Now they are taking this nuclear power to destroy this comet, okay? If it destroy, it will. Otherwise, at least they can change its way, okay? They can't come and hit to the Earth. So like that, they have decided. And now, later, this could be done by placing the nuclear payload in a spaceship, sending it to intercept the approaching comet and detonating it by remote control. So they have decided, all the experts are suggesting that how can they have to, they have to exploit, they have to bring a explosion on this space, is it? So now they have to payload, means they have to overload a spaceship with the nuclear missiles, okay, with the nuclear power. So they have to overload it, and now, so they have to control by the remote, okay, on the Earth. okay? No person is going on the spaceship. So just only they are send a nuclear power in that spaceship to destroy this comet, okay? So then they have to control from the remote, okay? So now again there is a, again they have a, one of the important task here to do this, to reach this goal, they have some important task. So what are the task here? Okay, by success or a failure, secrecy must be preserved. If it is a success or a failure, then everybody should keep this secret. What the things should be happening, they have to keep it this one secret. You know, if it is not secret, if they were spread this news to the world, what will happen? The people are, they are in a panic. They will not listen any words of the government. They will break the laws. Okay, they can destroy anything. The people, they can't listen any of them. Because they, if they know that the world is going to an end, so the people are really, they can't, no one can control this huge crowd, is it? So that's why the, all the things they are keeping here secret, okay? So next is, finally, a timetable was drawn up for the operation, which was codenamed Project Light Brigade. The important dates in it were, okay? So finally, they were decided, okay? So what they have decided? So they have to send a nuclear power spaceship on the space to destroy this comet, okay? So they have to fix a plan here. They are planning and they have fixed dates for this, okay? And they given the name for this mission, that is, the name of the mission is Project Light Brigade. So this is the name of this mission, sorry, mission, not mission, it's a mission, okay? So this is the name of this mission. So like this way, and now they have chosen some important dates with their calculations, okay? So all these things should be happen on which day, on what timing, and everything they have to be schedule it, okay? Now October 10th, so the first date they have fixed is October 10th, okay? The first date they have fixed for this is October 10th. Okay, October 10th. Dispatch the spacecraft with the payload unless by then the comet is already destroyed by natural causes or change its path due to the unforeseen reasons. Okay, so now on this date, that is the October 10th. So they have to be payload, means they have to load it a spacecraft with the nuclear power or a lot of explosions, explosive missiles in that. And if it is not going to happen, so the comet, it will be destroyed by itself naturally. Otherwise, it can change its way or its directions, okay? So like that, they have to plan there, okay? So all the experts, they have planned like this. So they on this day, they have to be load payload to the spacecraft with the missiles, the nuclear missiles. Then next is November 15th. So the next date they have set for, November 15, it is set for what? It is pronouncing as a rendezvous. Okay, so not rendezvous, it's a rendezvous. It's a pronunciation it has given here. So we should have to pronounce like this way. Rendezvous, so it was with the comet and the detonation of the payload. Okay, so what this is, it is a meeting place. So rendezvous, it's a meeting place. Okay. So what is the meeting place here? The meeting place with the comet and this nuclear missile, okay? So the payload of the spaceship, this is the meeting place of the comet. Meeting place of the comet. Comet and also this space, this spacecraft, which is loaded with the spacecraft, which is loaded with the explosive missiles, okay? Either it is a nuclear or any other explosion materials, it is loaded. So that this date, it is fixed. It is a meeting place. So they have fixed the place where these two things are going to meet, okay? That is the comet and also spacecraft where the explosion is going to happen, okay? So they have decided rendezvous. So then next is December 15th. So the next date they have announced here is December 15th. Okay? So December 15th is the date of what? If the experiment failed, if this experiment is going to be failed, so this is the last step here. What is this? Failed, this was the day the comet would hit the earth. Okay? So on this date, this comet is hit to the earth. Okay? So this is the day. Which one? December 15th. Okay, so this was, and if it succeeded, this was the day the comet would pass by at a near but safest distance. If it is not happen, if this comet is not hit to the earth, so this comet is going to be passed near by the earth, but it is not going to hit. Naturally it is. Okay, so whatever the things they have decided, it's their plan and their artificial things to destroy the comet. But naturally, if it come nearer to the earth, so it is the safest thing for the earth, but it will be hit to the earth. That is the last day of the earth. So they have decided like this. Okay, now what happened? So now I hope that you all are understood that what is the plans and procedure and how they come into the final conclusion, how they are solving these issues, okay, resolving it, and what are the plans and things they have sketched and they have scheduled it, and how the plans are going to be succeeded or not. Okay, let's see in this further story here. So next is, the success of the experiment depended on how massive the comet was. Actually, they don't know what is the size of the comet. Okay, so massive means it's the size of the comet actually. So here, the success, it is dependent on the experiment, on if they are experiment, because they are loaded the spacecraft with the explosives. Okay, so then they don't know that how much the size of the comet is. Okay, so here, so if it is going to be success, this experiment, but here it comes, there is a size of the comet. Nobody would estimate, everybody hoped that it was not a very massive. So no one knows that what is the size of the comet which is nearer to the, which it is passing by the earth. Okay, but they just estimated, or everybody has estimated, and they are hoping that it is not very big one, it is not very large one. Okay, so this one. Now, do you think we will succeed? Datta asked Sir John MacPherson for his opinion. So when Datta Dai is also present in that conference, so then he asked to the Sir, here, Datta Dai asked question to Sir John that we will succeed in this. So he asked the question. Then, during the week, the two had developed considerable affinity for each other. So in that, within the week, because for a week time means for a long week, it has took a time together, they have spent a time together and they become a friends here. Okay, so now here Datta Dai has asked a question to the John MacPherson, is they are going to be succeed here or not. Then affinity means here, affinity means natural attraction for something. So they both are naturally, they were attracted each other. Who? John MacPherson and also Datta Dai. Then, Mr. Datta, I will give you an honest answer. So on the response of the, on the question of this Datta Dai, so now John MacPherson is responding to his question. What he says here, I will give you an honest answer. I'm not buying any Christmas present till December 15th. So December 15th. You know, this is the one of the great month for the Christians. You know, the 25th. 25th is the day of a Christmas. And after that, there is a New Year's. There is a New Year celebration. Okay, so now, he frankly speaking, with the honestly he is speaking, before 15th of December, he is not going to buy any Christmas present, any Christmas gift. So they are not sure what will happen to the earth. Okay, so this is the answer. This is the answer in this way he has given to the Datta. Okay, so then Datta Dai toured the British Isles for 2 weeks after the conference, and he had a pleasant time visiting observatories and exchanging views with amateur as well as the professional astronomers. So the conference was ended with this solution. Okay, so with the plans and solution, with this procedure, the conference was ended. Now Datta Dai was was having a tour in that British place, okay, that is in England, and he was stayed for another 2 weeks there, and he was enjoying a good time there, and he was visited observatories, and also he was exchanging their views and ideas with the amateur scientists and other astronomers who are professional astronomers, okay. So like that he was did in the British Isles. Then on his return, he was greeted by the inevitable vast crowd of friends, social leaders, students, and the usual hangers-on. So when he was returned from this conference, so there were huge crowd to meet to Dattara. Okay, so who are those people? They are the friends, they are the relatives, they are the politicians, okay, they are the leaders and also the students. They were gathered to meet him, loaded with garlands and bombardment by questions from the press. He somehow made his way to the waiting car. So when he was arrived in Kolkata, so many people were used to put a garlands with the loaded garlands with so many flowers, okay, and then there are a lot of questions. Bombarded means a lot of questions. The press was, media was asked to Datta, and somehow he was went to the waiting car. He was not only responded a single answer to their questions, okay. He just went in his way, okay. Then next is what happened in the second part. Let's see in the next class. I hope that you all are understood this, how this comet Datta is an inevitable thing for all the astronomers, for all the experts, and even Datta also, because he is the person who has discovered this new comet. If he could not discover it, so they can't plan those things, is it? So this kind of discoveries are very important for the people and for the world, okay. You know, this is one of the great contribution of Datta. So where he has not only he was made his name and he was saved the world from this kind of destruction, okay. So this is about the today's class. I hope that you all are enjoying this one. We will meet you in the next class. Till then, all of you stay home, keep learning. Thank you.